It's Saturday the 7th of January 2017 for the second time today, dear. The second time. First of all, you had the recorded show, and now we are coming live, boys and girls. Well, we might be live if you're watching us live. If it's coming up to 20 to 11 on Saturday the 7th of January 2017 UK time, then you are indeed with us live. If it's another time or day, then I'm afraid you're watching a recording. But don't go away, because you might miss something. You never know, you might miss something. Let's say hello to the early birds. That's those people who are with us right at the beginning of the show. Hello to Terry. Evening, Terry H. Hi, Terry. Now, what was it? Oh, you were getting excited about something the other day. I can't remember what it was. Something on the television. Oh, Big Brother. Oh, please, Terry. Please. You must have grown out of that by now. Big Brother, dear. Good evening to Kim, who's with us this evening. Lives near my sister up there in Woodhall Spa. Good evening, Kim. Wendy's with us this evening in Lancashire. John Child is with us in London, 206. Evening, John. He's the one that sang Kingston Town last night at the karaoke night. We've got Julian. Hello, Julian. Julian used to come along to the London Bridge karaoke when I was doing that at Belushi's. Good evening, Julian. Nice to see you, sir. Jerry Green's with us. Callum's with us. He's up to north as well, aren't you? Callum's with us. Alton Andrews is with us this evening. Alton Andrews, I've known for, can you believe, Alton, now it's now 18 years. And Alton used to be a regular, what do you call it, a permanent presenter on Liberty Radio in London, 963 and 972. 963 and 972, Liberty. He was on that station for ages, and I kind of joined them for about, I think I was on there for about 18 months in the end. I was only supposed to be on there for 6 weeks, but that turned into about 18 months. But Alton has done years and years on all different radio stations all over the world, not just in this country. I think he's done BFBS, which is like a radio station for like army and service personnel and people like that. So he's with us tonight. Good evening, Alton. Hello to, there's an awful lot of people with us. Angel Hart's with us this evening. Angel, like, lives literally a minute away. Just on my road. Don't reveal where we are, Angel. You never know. Nasty men might come and break in and try to attack me. Terrible things could happen. They really could. Good evening to Rod Brown. Hello, Rod. Nice to see you again. You're always there now. Rod, you've become a bit of a regular. You'll become a regular. Ricky Bentley. Hello, Ricky. He works in Iceland. Good evening, Ricky. Matt Martins from Canada is there. Matt Joplin's there as well. Good evening, Matt. Nice to see you. How's it coming along with the DJing, dear? He wants to start doing mobile DJing. I've got a cup of tea with me. I learned from last time, you see. Wendy was a little bit concerned, so when she saw the sign come up that said live show coming up shortly, she said, make sure you have a cup of tea. How nice to be cared about and concerned for. Thank you, Wendy. I do appreciate that, my darling. I think that's all we've got time for. That's all we've got time for today. Thank you. Goodbye. No, not really. I'm still here. Don't worry. I'm not going anywhere. Not going anywhere. We've got loads and loads to chat about this evening, boys and girls. There's also a phone line, which I shall be opening a little bit later on. Let me just tell a story or two first, OK? We'll be opening the phone line a little bit later. When I finished it is wishful thinking, Angel, yes. It is wishful thinking. And actually, the whole thing about people breaking in... Excuse me. The whole thing about people breaking in is a little bit more serious today, and I shall come over to that in just a few moments' time. Don't rush me. We're going as fast as we possibly can, OK? just as I finished the show this morning, when I finished recording the show... Don't worry, that cough's not as bad as it sounds now. In fact, I've got a story about the cough coming up as well. It's all happening on the show today. Don't go away. So just as I finished the show today, there was a knock at my door. No, actually, it was just before I started. I don't think I told you about it this morning. And it was my neighbour. And she wanted to know if she could come into the garden. Now, going back about 12 hours or so, I got a text while I was at work, while I was on my way to work, actually, last night at about 7 o'clock at night. And it was from my lovely neighbour, Dave, who informed me that they were having work done to their conservatory roof. Now, they've had a conservatory next door to me for some time now. And I remember his lady, Karen, telling me that it's really quite cold in the winter. Now, when you see these things advertised, they never tell you that, do they? You know, you just imagine that, oh, well, you've got a greenhouse, basically a greenhouse on the side of your house, although it should be much warmer, all double glazed and that. Oh, wonderful. You know, you'll be able to sit out there now in the garden in the winter, basically. You think that, but not according to my lovely neighbour, Karen. She says it's really cold in there in the winter. They've got a small heater in there, but it doesn't really do much. And she said, if I ever had it done again, I'd have it done with a solid roof. Well, they've gone ahead and done this because you can have these glass roofs replaced by solid roofs, which I never knew. So they had arranged this to happen. Well, get this. So the scaffolder, because they've got to have scaffolding up, the scaffolder rings them up yesterday at 5 o'clock in the afternoon and tells them that they're coming Saturday morning. You know, I mean, wouldn't you give people a little bit more, you know, notice than that? How stupid can you be? Anyway, he said, is that they might need access to your garden. Would that be OK? And of course, you know, I said straight away, yes. Well, I've got such wonderful neighbours. And we do anything for each other. You know, if I go away and my mate can't feed the cat for whatever reason, then Dave will do it for me. You know, he takes parcels in, I take parcels in. So there's no problem with that at all. You know, it'd be a bit messy in the garden, but that's okay, no problem. You know, especially in the middle of winter. You're not going to use the garden in the winter, are you? And it'll be a bit messy. Come the spring, wherever they've walked, we'll all start growing grass again, and that's the end of it, basically. So I said yes, no problem, straight away. Anyway, so I came up yesterday. I got this morning, got the knock at the door. It was the people and they came in. I said, all right, just help yourselves. They're coming in and out as you please. No problem. Just close the door behind you if you go out for any period of time. So I just left them to it, basically. I came up here, did a show and then went back downstairs. They were still going in and out. So I popped next door to my neighbour, Dave. And I said, there's my keys. I'm just going down to the shops now. I'll be back in a couple of hours. And that was it. No problem at all. And it's so different. My nephew at the moment is having a extension built on the side of his house. Now, if you're a regular viewer, you'll know this. If not, just to tell you, my nephew has a severely disabled little girl. She's about 1.5 years old and she needs all sorts of equipment and special bed, large bed. She's only a tiny little thing. Special bed and oxygen things, you know, those bottle things, great big bottles of oxygen and all sorts of equipment attached to her at night. At the moment, they have a two-bedroomed house. They already have two little children. There's Evie, who's 4. I just had a FaceTime call with about an hour ago, actually. I don't know what she's still doing up at this time. Actually, I rung up my nephew. I think she heard me talking and came down the stairs to chat. And so there's her. There's Harry, who's, I think, 3 years old. And Olivia is the severely disabled one. She's about 1.5 years old. She has all sorts of problems, mainly blind. She has trouble breathing. Her lungs fill up with, you know, stuff, fluid stuff. And she can't walk. There's something wrong with her bones and things like that. So there's lots wrong with her. And the council have agreed to build this thing on the side, like an extension. It's only one story high for all the equipment and to give them another room, OK? And my nephew, so all this has started to happen, and my nephew has had no end of problems with his neighbour. Basically, they just don't want it built. I mean, you know, you can understand it, but there are certain things that you have to go through, you know, to either have it built or stop having it built, of the sort. So the neighbour has gone through all these channels trying to stop this thing being built. But at the end of the day, the council said, no, we're building this, basically, and is trying to have it built. And every 5 minutes, the neighbour is on the phone to the police complaining, you know, talking about my nephew, he's parked over a part of his thing, or a lorry's arrived, oh, the lorry's blocking my driveway. And it got to the point, I think, where last week, when the building work started, which I think was on the 3rd of January, so what was that? That was on Tuesday, you know, the first day back for many people after their nice long Christmas and New Year's break. The lorry and the neighbour got his car and parked so that the lorry couldn't park. Or not lorry, what's that thing, you know, skip. So the skip couldn't park. And, of course, they called the police, and the police came eventually and said, look, if you don't move it, we'll get a tow truck and move it. And that. And each time the police have seen that the neighbour is in the wrong. And I just want to say that's the kind of difference. You know, two opposite ends of the spectrum. There's me and my neighbour here, and we get on so well. We all get on well. All the neighbours here get on well. There's no problem with anyone here. Maybe we're all just lucky that we all live next door to each other. We do things for each other. And then if something needs to be done, then it gets done. You know, there's no trouble at all. A little bit of a messed garden for a few days, basically, in my case. Of course, my nephew's building thing on the side, that's going to take, I think they said it was going to be about 3 weeks. So obviously that's a bit better. But once it's done, it's done. Of course, the neighbour's argument at his end is that it's going to block his light off. Now, let me tell you, my neighbour, when I first moved it, he didn't have that conservatory. And my side, there is a brick wall, which is one level high, you know, one story high. And when I first saw it being built, I thought, oh, I'm going to lose some light. But I thought, well, you know, that's the way it is. You can't, you know, that's his land. He can do what he likes. But actually, once it was built, it made no difference whatsoever. And that's interesting, really, because the sun does come from that side. I have a west-facing garden, and the sun kind of comes over, so if that's my back garden, the sun comes over this way. It kind of comes around like that, you know. Okay, and his wall is here. So if it was going to block, it would. But it doesn't, because the sun is so high in the sky. So it made no difference to me whatsoever. In my nephew's case, the sun comes at the back. It doesn't even come over that way. So it's going to lose no light whatsoever. And it was all a bit like that. And it's ongoing, really. Every day something else happens. Every day the police have to keep going round there and having a go at him. But I think he's been given a warning now that he's wasting police time. So we'll see how that goes. But do you see what I mean there? And I wonder, have you had bad neighbours or anything like that? If so, how about calling in this evening and letting me know all about it? No names, no places. Just tell me if you've had a bad neighbour at some point, boys and girls. I'd like to know about that. And you'll be able to call in. Lines are now open. I can only take one call at a time. If more than one calls in at a time, then it's first come, first serve. And anyone else has to wait, I'm afraid. There's no one to answer the phone and say, we'll call you back. I'm afraid I'll either ring it or it'll go to answer phone if I'm already on a call. All right, so if I'm already on a call, don't try and ring in because you won't get answered. But have you had bad neighbours? Or, like me, have you got brilliant neighbours? I'd like to hear about that tonight. If you've got any stories for me, call in. Our phone lines are open now. Ding! Now, the phone-in number is a local London number. It's not a premium rate number at all. It's 020-8144-3477, OK? 020-8144-3477. If you have Skype, you can Skype in wherever you are in the world, completely free of charge. My Skype-in username is, all one word, United Kingdom Talk. The Skype is United Kingdom Talk. There's also a third method you can now use, which is the Facebook call button. So if you're watching us on Facebook, you must know that you can do Facebook calling. You can call in from that as well. Just press the little call button and you'll get through. So if you've got any stories like that at all, I'd love to know. Good neighbours, bad neighbours, whatever. What have your been experiences? Have you had a terrible time? Oh, I bet some of you had a terrible time. Then let me know, OK? 020-8144-3477. We have a call already. Good evening to Jerry. How are you, Jerry?
Good evening, Chris. Hope you're well.
All right, I'm very well this evening. I'm firing on all cylinders. All cylinders, dear.
As always, dear.
Now, are you ringing up about your neighbours?
Well, yeah. Well, round our area, round in Preston, Lincoln, we always got quiet neighbours, really.
Oh, and where is this?
This is in Preston, Lancashire.
Preston, and you've never had a problem with neighbours?
Never.
So you're lucky.
Not
as
yet, anyway.
You're lucky as well. Well, I reckon actually, Jerry, I reckon you're, I'm listening to your voice, to be honest, right? And I reckon you yourself might be one of those people that you wouldn't want to live underneath or next to.
Right. Because we live next, we've got, yeah, we live in a flat, we've got a next door and an upstairs as well.
Yeah,
so you've got plenty of loud music or anything.
I would imagine you're a little bit noisy and you upset the neighbours quite often. Would that be right, well, Joey?
Not really, because when I first had my last music next door, I said, okay, turn your music down a little bit, because we've got like a little walkway in the
middle.
Oh,
dear, dear me.
You can hear the bass, so I just turn it down just a little bit. I thought, oh.
Yeah, you've got that music up too loud, upsetting people, haven't you? And I bet you smoke and all the smoke's going out your window into your neighbours and all that. And you've got that...
Oh, do you know something? We get the odd drugs. Next door, texted.
Oh, do you get that smell in from them? Oh, no.
Yeah.
My mate, he used to live in a flat. He was the first floor. So it was a downstairs, first floor, and upstairs. And the bloke downstairs used to smoke that disgusting, smelly stuff. And it used to come up through his floorboards. How awful is that?
Oh.
Awful. And it stinks. It's worse than... It's worse than cigarette smoke, that stuff. It absolutely stinks, Joey, doesn't it?
Totally, because every time if we were in the kitchen making food or if next door smoking,
yeah,
we just smell it. It's like, oh, really?
Vile. No. Do you do any smelly cooking? Any sort of, let me think of any... I don't know, actually, I can't think of anything now. Like, chips are some of the worst stuff, you know.
Really?
If you don't open the doors and that while you're cooking chips, the entire place can end up smelling like a chip shop. Awful. You like chips? Do you like chips?
Oh, I love chips.
Oh, yes. You know what I've started buying now? Aunt Bessie's crinkle cut chips. Very nice. How comes the crinkle... How is it that the crinkle cut chips taste so much nicer than the other ones? What do they do to them? It's just that stuff, I don't know.
I don't know. I don't think I've ever heard of them, you know.
Have you not had crinkle cut chips before?
No.
Oh, well, you know, like you get a chip...
It must be a London thing. I've never heard of them. I've seen them.
Well, you know, like you get a straight chip. It's like straight, isn't it? Well, a crinkle cut chip, it's got like waves in it. So it's not cut straight. There's like waves, like a seaside, like waves.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's a crinkle cut chip, dear. You must get a bag and try them.
I will.
Yeah, put them in the old fryer, all right?
Yeah.
Okay, Joey. Now, just remember to keep the music down. However, if you're watching one of my shows, turn it full volume up so that people can talk to you, okay?
Yeah, and I'll put you on the 14th TV as well.
Yes, thank you very much.
You're welcome.
Nice to talk to you, Joey. Have a lovely evening,
you,
all right? Bye-bye now. Bye, Joey. Bye. There we are. Joey calling there from Boys and Girls. Now, I did get a call in, and I'm suddenly aware that it makes a noise, doesn't it? I wonder how I stopped that happening. I'm not quite sure I stopped the noise happening there. But call in if you want to. 028-8144-3477. Ross says, hello, not working tonight. Good evening. No, not working tonight. No, I've got, cut down on my nights, actually, Ross. I thought you knew that already. I have cut down on my nights. I now have off every Tuesday. I have most Sundays off. I just do one Sunday a month at the moment. And I have every other Saturday off. And that's where I am at the moment. And I'm happy with that. Happy with that. And this time next year, I'm going to cut back a little bit further. We need to slow down a bit so I can do more things I enjoy, like this. I love sitting here chatting away to people. It's just so wonderful, especially when they ring in as well, which is very nice. Hello to Alfie, who says the Queen nearly got shot. Who shot the Queen? Who's shooting the Queen, dear? Oh, the Queen nearly got... Oh, well, let's have a look at this. The Queen nearly got shot by her own guard as she took a 3 a.m. stroll. Good God. You know what she needs? Those trainers, you know, with the flashing lights. Of course, they would have to be blue because they're royal. Blue flashing lights on the trainers. Dear me. Who nearly shot the Queen? How embarrassing. Oh, my word. I bet that soldier was embarrassed. Did he actually fire a shot and miss? Or did he suddenly realise who it was? Was she walking her dogs? Poor Queen, she's not been too well, has she? Thank you, Ralphie. Callum says, I should be down this month for karaoke at King's Cross. Do you still do Camden? Not Camden, no. I do King's Cross only. That's Central Station, OK? King's Cross at Central Station. All right, another call coming in here from London. Hello, who's that? Hello? Who's calling from London? Speak now or forever hold thy tongue. No. Okay. If that one calls back, we'll see if that one comes back again later. Might have lost that one. Hello to Lily, who says, good evening, Chris. Good evening, Lily. Hope you're well tonight. We missed you last night. You weren't at the karaoke, Lily. Hello to John Coops. Joe says, sounds like a bit of a job's worth to me. Oh, absolutely, Joe. I know exactly. They are jobs worths. Don't you love jobs worth? They've usually got a clipboard, haven't they? They're very, very important people, jobs worths. Hello to Craig Adams, who says, good evening, Chris. People are nasty and rude in this world. I've got a few friends, and they are few, but I'm grateful for them. With me, it takes time to get to know new people, so I'm not so good around new people. But people who I do know, I'm fine. Oh, yes. Yeah, I mean, it's not necessary for, you know, for people to be like that, is that? I found this over the years. This is one of the reasons I got fed up with a lot of the DJing, because the people coming up and talking, you know, asking for music are so damn rude. Now, some of them, they don't even talk to you. They type in the request on their mobile phone and just hold it up to your face like that. I mean, how rude can you be? Absolutely. What made me stop doing Camden karaoke? Didn't want to do that one anymore. I wanted to cut down on the times, and there was a couple of little fights in there that I wasn't happy about. Nothing to do with me. So I left. And generally, if I'm fed up doing a job, I'll just go. I don't bother trying to change anything, because generally people don't listen or anything like that. So when you're fed up with somewhere, you need to know when it's time, and you just go and you look for either look for something else or have a night off like I have done now. Callum also says, my cat is biting me. Well, stop touching it inappropriately then, and it won't bite you, will it? There's too many people touching cats inappropriately and then not understanding why they're being bitten. Absolutely. Thank you, Callum. Hello to Adam this evening. We're going to do King's Cross for the evening on a Monday and come back. You feel free. No, you won't need to come back, Adam. You can come stay here. You can get not Callum, no, just you. Yeah, you can come and stay here, Adam. All right. Joe, hello, Joe. How old is you? You've got a little child. Have you still got just the one child? I remember Joe used to come dancing with his beautiful girlfriend. I don't know if you're still with that same lady. I haven't been following you, to be honest. To Belushi's in Hammersmith, where I used to DJ. And that's actually going back quite a way now. That must be at least 6 or 7 years now. But we had wonderful, wonderful, wonderful Saturday nights at Belushi's in Hammersmith, and I really, really enjoyed those. Okay. Good. So that's that. Call in if you want to. 0208 144 3477. Okay. Thank you very much to Mary this evening, who has now sent me in. If you saw the show this morning, she has now sent in a little video of her robotic new Hoover, which I'll try and show in either, if we do a recorded or live show tomorrow. If we do a recorded one, I'll show it in there. If not, I'll show you it on Monday. She's got a new robotic Hoover, and you just switch this thing on, and it goes around it, sucking up all the dust. How wonderful is that? I don't think it copes with stairs very well. You know, I think you've still got, I mean, the stairs is the worst thing, isn't it, ladies? You get down and all your back, you get up a little bit again and up and down the stairs. And I've got one of those upright Hoovers, and you kind of got to balance it because the wire doesn't go all the way up. You kind of got to balance it on one of the stairs and try and get up and down like that, haven't you? Anyway, so I was just telling you, once the neighbour, once they'd gone in and out, and then I went into town, I cycle into town generally. I rarely get my car out to go shopping or anything like that when I'm staying in Bracknell. Really, the car only comes out if I'm going into London or going to visit someone far away. The rest of the time, I'll either walk or take my push bike, and I cycled in. I'm so pleased it's warmed up, because it's been so cold the last couple of days, hasn't it? It really has. So it's warmed up now. So there I was on my bike with my coat and my little woolen hat. I have a selection of woolen hats. I had my little woolen hat on. And cycled in, and first of all, I went to the bank. They were pleased to see me because they'd run out of money, so I was able to give them a load more money. I went to the bank, and then I went to Waitrose after. I only spent about £12 in there today. What did I buy? I think some vegetables and things like that. I'm a bit lazy with vegetables. You know the pre-packed things? It's like layered vegetables. So you get like sweet corn and carrots and peas and a bit of cabbage in there, and you just you poke the top of this little plastic box and you stick it in the microwave for 3 minutes. Oh, it's so easy. Yes, lazy, but so easy. And probably an expensive way to do it as well. I mean, one of those is £2. And what could you, for £2, I mean, you could get a massive bag of carrots, couldn't you? You'd get carrots and everything for £2. So it's just a lazy way of doing it. Then I had a cup of tea in there. I was going to have tea and toast in there. But it was a half hour wait on the food. Bit sillier way to do that, actually. Because, you know, I can understand if you're having a meal, it's going to be half an hour. All I wanted was two slices of toast. I said, so, and I heard the lady in front of me order something. And she said, I'm afraid it's going to be about half an hour for food. They're very busy at the moment. Okay. And then when I got there, I said, will it be half an hour for toast? She says, I'm afraid it will. I said, well, how does that work then? And she said, well, they do it in order. You see, so as the orders come through, you've got to wait for that one to be done until she can do your toast. I mean, how long does it take to put two bits of bread in a bloody toaster, dear? And a piece of marmalade on top, please. We can't have toast without marmalade. No, my sister does delicious homemade marmalade. Yes, please. We'll have some of that. Yes, homemade marmalade. So in the end, I just had a bag of cheese and onion crisps and a cup of tea and I sat there. It's quite nice sitting in the cafe and Waitrose, just watching people. Do you do that? I like to watch people, what they're all doing, you know. And you wonder if there's stories, you know. There's a very, very old man who I see in there. Whenever I'm in there, he's there sitting there having a cup of tea. He looks quite well to do, you know, but he's always on his own. I think, oh, what sort of life have you had? You know, obviously retired now. And then you've got some builders sitting just behind me there. And two young ladies and a child sitting there. And I just sit there and I watch them all, you know, wondering what sort of lives they have. It's good, isn't it? And then from Waitrose, I think I cycled back here, had some lunch. I can't remember what else I did now. I think I did a bit of hoovering today and then come back here. I have recently been doing DIY as well. I'll tell you about that in a minute. Angel Heart says, we had new neighbours a few months ago and the parking round here can be non-existent. So I suggested they park in front of our garage while they were fully moved in. A few days passed when there was a knock at the door. My neighbours were so grateful they bought me an orchid and a bottle of wine. What a wonderful surprise. Isn't that lovely, Angel? But Angel's the lady that lives just up the road. Angel, the parking down this end, because she's up the top end, I'm down the bottom. The parking down this end is unbelievable now. There is a corner, you know, as you come down the end, to get to me, you turn left, don't you? Right? That corner there, the people that park, and you, there's no way a fire engine would get through. They park on that corner too close to each other, and there's just not enough room. I've come down that road before, gone to turn left, and I've had to stop and reverse back up the other way to line up so I can get through this gap. The parking down this road is really bad now. I mean, it's got like this in the last 9 months. I don't know what happened. I assume that more... Perhaps more families have grown up now and the children have got cars as well. And they park on the grass and on the pavement. And I hope you don't mind me telling people, Angel. Angel's actually in a wheelchair. Well, you know, Angel, I know what side of the road you are on. If you were to cross the road and try and go down that path there, there's a blooming car that always, it parks on the path. I don't mean a couple of wheels on, over the path. There's no way you get your wheelchair down there, my darling. Awful. And it can't be much better this side. There's another bloke up there. You know that turning. So if you was to come out of your house, turn left. And you know the first bit you cross over there. Sometimes a bloke parks across that. And you have to come out into the road and go around it. Now, I know there's nowhere to park. But blimey, why don't they just park up on the top on the main road there? It's ridiculous. Callum says you should watch Jeremy Carl. I've met him before. No, thank you. No, thank you. No, Jeremy Carl. The people on there are dreadful, ghastly people. Awful people. Do these people actually exist on Jeremy Carl? Or are they told to play up? That's the question I want to know. Callum, so have you been on... Have you actually been on... Please don't tell me you've been on Jeremy Carl. Otherwise, I will have to block you. You will have to be blocked, I'm afraid, if you've been on Jeremy. We can't have Jeremy Cole. What do you call contestants or things like that? We can't have Jeremy Cole, people. Have you been on Jeremy Cole? If you have, give us a call in and tell us about it. 0208 144 3471. I want to hear about this one. I want to hear about that. Rick's with us today. Hello, Rick in the USA. Rick Porter's with us today. Hello, Rick. It's a long time since I saw you. I hope you're doing well, sir. Oh, no, Callum was in the audience, were you? Callum was actually in the audience, so I beg your pardon there. Angel says you ought to go cycling with Richard and his friends on a Saturday. They only do around 90 miles. What? In what? How can you do 90 miles in a day on a bike? My God, no. I can just about get down to town and back. Sundays, actually. Angel, Sundays I do a long journey. I cycle to Wokingham on Sundays. I don't come past you because I kind of go down the back past the co-op just down there. So I go down the back and I soak at Wokingham to the church. You know, the Corpus Christi Church in Wokingham. So I'm usually on my bike about 8:30 in the morning. On a Sunday, it's a lovely time to be up. There's no one around. I don't know if you know the roads in Wokingham, but the back roads are Waterloo Road and all round there. And I go across the level crossing and there's no one around. It's so quiet and lovely. And I get to the church and, of course, there's all these cars pulling up. And there's me on my bike and that. Yeah, so I do a lot of cycling. Yes. Joe says, haven't seen you in person since Hammer Superlucia's days. Good to hear you're still doing the DJ thing. Only just, Joe. Only just. I don't do much DJing now. I much prefer doing karaoke and quiz nights. I do one DJ and night that I quite enjoy on Thursdays in London, but mainly do karaoke now. Rick says, Jeremy Carl is a freak show. Absolutely. Yeah, but it's like all those programmes. Celebrity Big Brother. They're not normal people. Freaks. Every last one of them are a freak. How can you honestly act like that or be like that and consider yourself normal? I mean, I'm really pushing the boat here, but I would put money on it that I'm more normal than all those people that go on Celebrity Big Brother or places like that. Dreadful. Dreadful, dreadful, dreadful. So again, I try and keep up with the messages as much as I can. It's a pity you don't come to Nottingham. What's for me in Nottingham? There's nothing for me to do in Nottingham, dear. Karaoke or anything like that. How long would that take me? It would take me about 2 hours to get there. I was asked to do a job actually in Norwich a couple of weeks ago, but I looked at the map and it would be like 3 hours to get there. Now I have done that before. Oh, hang on a minute, has something gone wrong there? Have you got that number still on the screen? You have, haven't you? Yeah, sorry, I thought something had gone wrong there. I did actually working in Norwich at a club called The Loft. That's going back about 18 years now. And I remember then the journey was a real nightmare. And I think the night used to finish about 2 a.m. I wouldn't get back here till 3. And then one week, and I'll never forget this, it was in January. And snow had been forecast. And the governor says, you can stay at mine tonight. I've got a spare room. And that's all right. I'll go home. Anyway, so it finished. So the night finished about 2 a.m, I think it was. And I left there. And just coming out of the sky was the occasional little flake of snow. So I thought, oh, that's all right. You know, I'll be OK with that. No problem at all. Anyway, so I got on my way and I'm going. I'm out of the city centre now. And I'm going along a main road. I don't know what it was called, but towards London. So you go towards London and then kind of M25 and then round to me. And then all of a sudden, this snow just came down from nowhere. Oh, my God, it was pouring down. And within a very, very short space of time, you could not actually see the road. You couldn't. And it was pouring down. I'm inching forward now. And I look to the right hand side. Where the fields were already covered in snow and I could see the electricity lines were going, all sparks flying off the electricity lines and everything. And it was awful. And fortunately, there was a great big lorry in front of me that somehow I caught up with. I think he was going very slow as well. So I was able to sit in, I wasn't that close, you know, but I was able to sit in his tracks. Because I was having trouble keeping straight in the car and I didn't get home that day till about 8, I think it was about 7 or 8 o'clock in the morning. Well, it was horrendous, the snow. And that's, I've had that twice, actually. That's happened twice to me. The other time was in London. I suppose this would be about 6, maybe 7 years ago. And I was working in Clapham. Now, Clapham is about 50 minutes drive from me. And anyway, I finished the night. It was 2 o'clock on the Sunday morning. Monday morning. And I was driving home. And once again, this snow came down from nowhere when I joined the M3. And very quickly, you couldn't see where you were. I mean, that was even worse than the Norfolk one, because I couldn't actually see in front of me, you know. And what I had to do on the motorway was go over into the fast lane and follow the barrier. That's how bad it was. Couldn't see the road at all. I had to follow the barrier. And I was very, very lucky. There were other cars there that had got stuck on the side. And I managed to keep moving. And eventually I got home. But, you know, like 20 mile an hour, you mustn't risk it. I mean, these idiots that tear up and down the motorway in fog and snow are unbelievable. Have you seen them? Idiots. Wendy says, I had an incident like that on the M62. Is that the, that's like going upwards, isn't it? The M62, one year coming back from my mum's in Lincolnshire with snow. It was very scary. Oh, it really is. It really is very, very scary driving in snow. I have actually spun two cars round on ice, snow or ice. And I wasn't going that fast either. That's the whole joke about it. There's me. And it was actually at exactly the same point. There's a bit where the M3 starts. It kind of goes up and then around to the side. And pouring down with snow or ice. It might not have been snowing at the time. I don't think it had been snowing at the time. But the snow was there on the ground along with the ice. And I'm coming up to this. I'm doing about, honestly, 25. I wouldn't lie to you. 25 mile an hour I'm on. I'm on the slow lane, of course, the inside lane. And when I've gone to turn, it just hasn't turned. It literally hasn't turned. And then it's going towards the wall. And then, you know, it's very difficult once it goes on ice. And then the whole thing has happened twice in the same place. And the whole thing just spun around and I end up facing the other way. I mean, thank God there's nothing coming behind me. It eventually, you know, I was able to get back over to that side and continued on my journey going very slowly. But then, you know, as I said just now, there were people in the overtaking lane right on the right hand side. Must have been doing 50, 60, 70 mile an hour. I just spun it at 20. You know, maybe there's something to be said for being too careful. I don't know, really. Oh, it's dreadful. And Wendy says it's a horrible thing being out of control. Well, it is. Well, of course, I've been out of control for years, as you well know, Wendy. Have been, darling. What did you think when Paul Walker died from Fast and Furious? Sorry, Callum, I don't know who that is, Paul Walker. No idea who that is. And what's Fast and Furious? Is that a film? Don't know who Paul Walker is, Callum. All right. Craig says, I never watched TV like Big Brother. Awful show. And Jeremy Carl, awful show. Now, Emmerdale on Coronation Street are great. Not my cup of tea, but I see where you're coming from. Holby City Casualty, fantastic. I am a Holby City and Casualty person. I haven't seen Casualty yet. I did see an excellent programme tonight, which I'll come on to in a minute. Casualty, great. Thunderbirds, are go. Computer graphics rebooted series. Doctor Who, those are the TV shows. Oh, they're excellent. They're excellent. Talking of cold weather, Rick Porter says in Pittsburgh, USA, it's going to be minus 14 tonight. Oh, glad I'm not there, mate. Glad I'm not there, Rick. I hope you've got central heating, or have you got a real log fire where you burn real wood? Oh, that's nice, isn't it? A real log fire. How comfortable is that? Very, very nice. Callum says it's a street racing film. I don't think I've seen that. I honestly don't think I've seen that, Callum. All right. Now, what was I just about to tell you? Oh, yes. So a programme I saw tonight. Really, really good. It's a talent show and it's called Let It Shine. Hosted by what's his name now? Graham Norton. I wish he'd shave that beard off. It makes him look really dirty. Oh, it's horrible. I mean, I don't mind a little bit of stubble, you know, on young lads. But if you're that old, for Christ's sake, get rid of that horrible old grey beard. I hate it. And it looks all right on some people, but not on him. It just makes him look filthy and dirty. Although I must say, Graham Norton had a wonderful little purple shiny suit on. I was tempted. I was tempted to look that up. I bet that's not a Ted Baker. Oh dear, no. Very, very smart it was. So it's him. And it's Gary Barlow. He's looking for people to star in his stage show, All About Take That. And it's really very, very good. The opening was fantastic. You saw Gary Butler in a shower. Not Gary Butler. Gary and Barlow in a shower. Gary Butler's my nephew. Gary Barlow in a shower. Yes, dear. I don't know if he was naked. You didn't see that bit. Did you think you would? Honestly, what is wrong with you people? Anything for a bit of flesh. Do you want me to take something off now? I'm quite hot in here, actually, today. I don't really want to turn the blooming heating on. Shall I open the window? Is the heating on then? The heating's not on. I don't know why it's so hot in here. Just a minute. Let me find my cool air device. I don't know where the remote control's gone. I thought it was over here somewhere. Oh, there it is. Let me put this on. It's very, very hot in this room tonight. I don't know why. Yes, so they're looking for people for this stage show. And there's, as always, there's four judges, but they're not nasty. They're not nasty. Now, this is where I have a problem with the X Factor, because they can be downright nasty on there. They're not nasty on here, and they give advice to the people. And then what the four judges have to do is give everyone a mark out of five. OK, but the judges don't know what each judge is giving them. So they write this down on some sort of, there seems to be some sort of computer screen underneath the desk so that the other judges can't see what they give them. Now, and then on the stage, it's very clever, actually. So you've got the contestant on the stage who's just sung their number. And they were all very, I have to say, all very good. Some of them weren't hitting the right notes. I mean, there was no one who you would say, oh, it's really, really, it's not like listening to me sing. You know, when people say, oh, my God, he's really, really bad. It's not like that. They were all reasonable singers. So they stand on the stage, big stage like that, you know, the sort of thing. And in front of them is like a runway. And on that runway is stars in on the floor of the stage, like big yellow stars. And there's, I think, there's 15 stars, okay. So it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. And then the person is standing, I think, on the 15th star, right? They're standing on the 15th star. And then there's another 16, 17, 8. There's another 5 stars around them, making 20, okay? Now, I just said to you, there's 4 judges and they can give them up to 5 points each. So then the judges write down their scores and then Graham Norton says, OK, let's see what the judges have given. And then these stars light up. So you're at star number 14. They need 14 points. I think it's 14 points to get through to the next round. OK, so then these stars light up. Boom, 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 boom. And as it gets closer to the person, they start slowing down. Boom. And you're thinking, oh, no, go on, go on. And then, if they're lucky, the star they're standing on lights up, which means they've then got through. Oh, so then everyone claps. And then if they've got any more, they light up around them. And they go, jun, jun, jun. And 2 people got 20 out of 20 stars. It's very exciting and so much better than that dreary old X Factor with the very, very boring Simon Cowell and cast. I'm sorry, dear. It's had its day. Get rid of it, dear. I'm still hot in here. Oh, is that not working? Just a moment, please. Are you coming on or what? Or maybe it's too cold, so it won't work. Will it? How does that work now? I've had this air thing in here for years. I still don't know how it works. So very good. Did anyone see it? The programme tonight, Let It Shine. I shall be absolutely watching that every week, I think. And we've had a few excellent talent shows over the year. I think the X Factor at the beginning, it wasn't too bad at all. I think it's run its course now. I really do. And for me, a talent show is absolutely about the contestants, not about the judges. And when you watch the X Factor, it's all about the judges. You know, they think they're the big stars and all that. That's not what a talent show is to me. There's been a couple of good talent shows over the years, both versions of Opportunity Knocks, of course, with Huey Green on Thames Television. And on BBC One with Bob Monkhouse, he did Opportunity Knocks for a while, didn't he? We had New Faces on ITV years ago. Now, that's and they had that woman, Nina Mishkoff, and she was horrible. She was really horrible to some of the contestants. And there was a show, also a talent show on BBC Two a number of years ago. I think it was 2008, something like that. And that was hosted by the Cockney bloke who was in EastEnders for a while. Can't think of his name for a minute. Oh, not Bradley Walsh. Now, what was his name now? Curly Black Hair. You know what I mean, don't you? It was hosted, I'm sure it was hosted by him. And that was nice as well. And with that one, you won, but audience, they all had buttons. And they all had to push buttons, and that's how you got through. So a number of good talent shows over the years. Perhaps you remember some. Do you remember talent shows? Any that stick in your mind you want to tell me about? Send us a message or indeed call in if you want to. 020-8144-3477, OK? 020-8144-3477. If you've got Skype, you can call in on Skype, United Kingdom Talk. Of course, if you're watching a recording, you can't call in, all right? Don't try and call in if you're watching a recording because you won't be able to get through to anyone. Or you can use the Facebook call-in as well, all right? Danny Dyer. No, it wasn't Danny Dyer, Wendy. It wasn't Jamie Foreman. No. No. It would have been about 50 years old, I think, the bloke who hosted this talent show on BBC Two. Maybe I can find it. Junior Showtime. I don't remember Junior Showtime. Hello, Gary. Oh, Gary, I meant to tell you, that Christmas card you gave me for Mary, I eventually delivered it yesterday. Sorry about that. She got the present ages ago. It's just the Christmas card that I failed to deliver until yesterday, but she has got it now. All right, Gary, thank you. Showtime. I don't remember Showtime, no. Don't remember Showtime. Wendy remembers Nina Mishkoff. Oh, she was horrible. Horrible lady. John, there we go. John also saw Let It Shine Tonight. Fantastic opening, I have to say. Really, really good opening to that and well thought out. I like the whole thing, the whole concept. It all really ticked all the boxes for me. Fantastic show. Wendy's going to watch it a little bit later on the BBC iPlayer. Oh, yes. Gary says he should just come to Central. Who's that? Who's that? Gary Barlow in the shower. We're like that. Tweety says, have you discussed your birthday plans for the year yet? No, I don't know what I'm going to do for my birthday. I've no idea what I'm going to do for my birthday this year. No idea at all. Got a call coming in. Don't know who this is. Hello, who's on the line, please?
Hello?
Hello, who's on the line?
This is Eric.
What's your name, Derek?
You have your
own number?
Eric.
Hello, Eric, where are you?
I'm in the US.
In the US? You're watching the show, are you?
Which show?
Are you watching the show at the moment? Why are you calling?
I feel like I have the wrong number, sorry.
Oh, where did you get my number from? Did you want to speak to Chris? Strange people, dear. Oh, we're having fun on the funds tonight. Come on. Fun on the funds. Fun on the phones tonight. Call in if you want to. 020-8144-3477. Gary W says, I love my log fire in the winter. Makes home so cosy. Oh, I'd love a log fire. I nearly had one put in here once, but I don't have a chimney, and I'd have to have one of those tubes. I don't know what you call them, those tubes going all the way up the wall. And I have seen those outside a couple of people's houses. And honestly, they're making it look like you're running a chip shop from in here, dear. I don't want all the local kids turning up. Can I have a portion of chips, please, knocking on my door, dear? Portion of chips, please. No, we're not a chip shop, my love. How dare you? It's quite nice to have these mystery callers this evening. Mystery callers. Do you want to be a mystery caller? Call in 0208 144 3477. I haven't watched. John says he watched The Voice on ITV. I haven't seen that there. I've got that on the video. I've got loads of stuff to watch at the moment. When I finish the show, I'm probably going to... Actually, I fancy going for a walk. I know it's like up past 11 at night, but I do like a nice late night walk. And I go... I do about an hour if I go for a walk. But I also want to watch Casualty and The Voice. I've got those to watch at the moment. Yes, lovely. So that was the programme... Let It Shine. They also had that girl at one of the judges. So there's Gary Barlow, there's Danny Minogue. I quite like Danny Minogue. So two who were on the X Factor, you know. There's the girl from Dreamgirls. I think she's in Dreamgirls, the show, which I actually want to go and see. Dreamgirls, you know that show where the Dreamgirls and that iconic song, and I am telling you. Yes, there's no way. There's no way. No way of leaving without you. Or something like that, I think it is. I can't remember the rest of the words. It's all very complicated. So there's her in it. And Gold. There's that bloke from Spandau Ballet. What's his name? He was in EastEnders as well, wasn't he? The bloke in Spandau Ballet. I'm trying to think of what the BBC 2... Let me just... BBC Two talent show. What did I say? 2008, I said, didn't I? 2008. Let's have a look. Don't know. What was it? Uh, 2008 in British television? I don't know. BBC Two talent show. Hang on. BBC Two talent show. Oh, his name is right on the tip of my tongue now. I can't find it. I don't know what that was now. Dad Simon watched the talent show. No, I don't know. Wait, Brian Connolly. That's it. Brian Connolly. Was he in EastEnders, Brian Connolly? Maybe I'm wrong. Maybe it wasn't in EastEnders, I don't know. But it was him, and it was called Let Me Entertain You. And it was really good, actually. It was on every night on BBC Two, and I enjoyed it. I enjoyed it anyway. Hello today to Tony Power, who joins us this evening. Tony writes songs for the Eurovision Song Contest and other stuff as well. Wendy's Martin Kemp, thank you very much. Martin Kemp, John Kim, Rosemary, Martin Kemp, Tweety. Yes, so he's the other one. Gold! So the four judges. It's really good. Please watch it next week or watch it on the BBC iPlayer. John says, I'll come and watch Dreamgirls with you. I've got someone to go and watch it with me, actually. The lady, the manageress from the King's Head Theatre Bar, where I do the quiz on Wednesday nights. That returns this week. I've got really itchy ears suddenly. Does that mean anything? Maybe something has crawled in here. Oh, that's better. Oh, dear. Don't you like... It's like to have a good itch sometimes. Although in certain places, you know, you have to try and hide it, don't you? You don't want anyone seeing you have these itches or anything like that. Now, I was saying about this cough, right? I've had this cough for about 4 weeks. It doesn't affect my breathing. Doesn't make me... It's not like that. It's just this phlegmy cough that keeps on and on. I've known so many people go down with chest problems and coughs this year. Well, in the Daily Mail this morning, check this out. A hacking cough that can last for weeks. Hello? Hello? Is that called a hacking cough? Is that a hacking cough? Dear, a hacking cough that can last for weeks has hit thousands of people across the country, but doctors say there is nothing they can do to help. Even talking about it makes it worse, doesn't it? GP surgeries have reported seeing a large number of patients with the nasty cough which cannot be treated with antibiotics. Because they say the old antibiotics are given out too much, don't they? And that's why some of them are starting to fail now. Those suffering with the hacking cough have been advised to rest and drink plenty of fluids. Rest, dear. We can't do rest. You're a long time dead. We can't do rest. I can't just sit there and do nothing. I'm not one of those sort of people, I'm afraid. I'm really not. One of the main symptoms of the virus is a hacking cough, which can take up to 3 weeks to clear. Well, how long have I had this? It's been about 4 weeks now. I've had this cough about 4 weeks now. This doctor in Cardiff told Wows Online. I don't know what that is, some sort of newspaper. In most cases, unless the patient has another underlying chronic condition, like heart or lung disease or diabetes, there is nothing the GP can do to help, other than recommend resting and drinking plenty of fluids. Antibiotics will be of no help to most normal, healthy people. Are you normal? No, I didn't think so. Me neither, my darling. If you see blood or are breathless, no breathless with your symptoms, have lost weight. We wish, dear. Mind you, I said to you I wanted to lose about a stone and a half by the first week in April. And of course, I think it was last week, or was it Monday? It might have been Monday. Ray Reynolds, singer extraordinaire who plays the ukulele and comes and sings at the karaoke and many other places, he bought me in this massive bar of galaxy chocolate. I mean, it was like this. I'm not joking. You know, there's the normal one, isn't there? There's the other one, which seems to become the normal one now, which is about that size. And there's this one. And he bought me in one of those, you know. And I thought I'll have a little bit at a time. And I can't. It must be an addiction to the sugar. Once you've opened that packet, I can't have it. I just have a square and then put it away. In fact, talking about it now makes me want to go out on my walk and buy another one. Another large galaxy chocolate. But I mustn't do it, dear. We must lose a bit of weight. Experts believe that the adenovirus is behind this winter's hacking cough and cold, rather more than the common rhinovirus. Well, haven't been any rhinos round here to catch a cold or cough off, dear. God's sake, man. Anyone else got that cough? Who else has got that nasty cough, eh? Wendy says they are very Moorish. That's the point. What, the galaxy? Oh, it's very, very nice. It's very, very nice. Very, very nice indeed. Tony, there you are. Tony's had it for 4 weeks. So about the... I must have caught it from you, Tony. When you came into the two brewers that night, dear. 4 weeks. I've had mine about four or five weeks, I reckon I've had mine. Certainly had it over Christmas. But it's nowhere near as bad as it was. When it first started, sorry to have to tell it. I'll just say it as it is. But the stuff coming up tasted absolutely vile. You know, something comes up. Generally, it doesn't taste. This tasted, I know nothing like it I've tasted before. Really awful. Rosemary suggests I drink hot lemon. Hot lemon tea breaks up the phlegm and honey soothes the tickle. Oh, we like a bit of honey. Honey, yesterday my life was filled with rain. Yes. Honey soothes the tickle, an old home remedy that works. I must try it. Although I don't really have too much of a problem at the moment. Wendy says, when did you finish the bar the cat bought you? Oh, God, that was ages ago, Wendy. That got finished that night I opened the envelope, dear. Because the cat secretly posted me a bar of chocolate for Christmas, you know. I've had that already, Wendy. God, that went ages ago. Gary says, good luck to Craig with his hospital radio show. He's been doing that for some time now. So there we are. All right. I think is that about it today? I think we're done today, are we? Oh no, there's a solar eclipse coming. There's a solar eclipse coming, boys and girls. Now, it will only be partial here. I don't know how partial, though. You know, will most of it be gone? Or will only a little bit of, you know, sometimes you get the sun there and a partial eclipse can be just that little bit of corner on the end there. Bit of a waste of time. Anyway, they're at it again. The doomsday people. On August the 21st, there will be a solar eclipse that will be visible across the UK and USA, it says, in which paper is it? Oh, in the Super Sore Away Daily Express. Oh, yes. August's solar eclipse will be the first in a century to travel all the way from the East Coast to the West Coast of America. And believers reckon it will be the beginning of the end. Oh, no! August solar eclipse, the faithful believe, it's actually Christians, the faithful believe that the beginning of the end actually started back in 1947 when Israel was created, and it goes on and on, so there we are. You know the old story, dear me, the doom mongers. Yes, the solar eclipse is coming, but it won't be any as good as we saw the one in, was it 1999 we saw a solar eclipse? I think it was around that date, wasn't it? Hello to Sean Michael Crabtree. Just joined us. You're very late, Sean. We've been here for an hour, dear. Where have you been? Do you want me to start all over again? Cool, dear me. It's a bit much, isn't it? Yes. Rosemary says a good old hot toddy cures it all. Well, send one round, dear. I don't know anyone called Toddy. Please send them round, yes. News on the mugs. The mugs have been ordered. Okay? United Kingdom Talk mugs have now been ordered. To start with, I've only ordered 20. So they are being made, and I'm not collecting them until the end of February. My sister is making these for me. How nice is that? Hey, my sister is making these for me. So I'll let you know when they're done. And I shall show you one on air. And if you want one, you might get one. You might get one, all right? The mugs are on their way. They have now been ordered. See? See? Sometimes things are not instant with me, you know. You've got to wait a little while before things happen. Don't rush me. Don't rush me. Now, what else was I going to tell you about? Oh, my DIY. I've done DIY. I have been Chris Reardon's DIY. I've been fixing things today. First of all, my computer. I don't know if you remember, a few weeks ago, I kept getting Google is out of memory messages on my thing. And eventually this morning, after I finished the show, and I come back, had my lunch, come back up here, and I thought, well, I'll tackle a few things today while I've got a time. And it was simply a case of clearing my cache on the Google Chrome that I use, which is quite an easy thing to do. So if you've got if you've got loads of web pages open and you find things are really slowing down a lot, not loads, but if you've got, say, 3 or 4 open, you should be able to open 3, 4, 5 without too much of a problem. Then try, and you start saying out of memory, then try clearing your cache. It's quite easy to do. On the right-hand side of the Chrome, there's like 3 dots. Just click on there, then click Settings, then click Show Advanced Settings, and then in there it says Clear Browsing Data. Just click that, and that should sort you out. Now, be warned, that may also clear your passwords, so make sure you know your passwords and usernames, OK? You might have to put all those in once more again, but it will clear everything out, and that seems to have made the change there. Okay, that all seems to be working now. John says we will be able to purchase the said mugs. I might just send them, dear. I might just send them out for nothing. I haven't decided yet, John. They're a little bit expensive, but you're worth it to me, my. Well, not you in particular, but you know, some people are worth. Some people are worth it, John. Some people who are worth it will be getting, and it's nothing to do with looks. Don't worry, John. Now, you don't have to be, you know, sort of 30, 35 years old, tattoos, muscles. Oh, I've come over all hot again. Reminds me of that Gary Barlow's not looking bad for 40 odd, is he? Mind you, I had quite a nice shape when I would, until it got to 47, and then it all went outwards for some strange, unrepressible reason. Yes. So that's the computer fixed. Then I tackled my stain on the carpet that no one has been able to help me with. Twice I asked for that. No one was able to give advice. I got some of this stain stuff and you spray it. My ear has become very itchy. I don't know why. I'm sure something has crawled into it. I asked a couple of times. No one seemed to know what to do with that. So I bought this stain stuff. And you spray it on and then you're supposed to get the cloth and go inwards with it. And that's kind of removed it. You know, to be honest, you can't see it unless you look for it now. So that's good. Of course, I know it's there. So I suppose that's going to be bothering me until I replace the carpet. The carpet's been out 2 years now. But I mean, it's a good carpet. There's nowhere whatsoever on that carpet. It shouldn't be for the price I paid for that from John Lewis, dear. You know, I intended to put it down. And the funny thing is, I had it done with that Scotch Guard. Well, it hasn't made any blood. It's supposed to be with that Scotch Guard. If you spill something, it comes up straight away. What a load of old rubbish that is. Because the stain's still there. You can still see it if you look for it. But actually, it's not too bad at all. So I fixed that. And I've also, this week, fixed my piano. Now, what happened on my piano? I've got a piano downstairs. It's about 16 years old. It's an electric piano. Yamaha Clarinova or Clarinova. I can't remember exactly what it's called. But I put my headphones in there. And I was listening. Sometimes I put the headphones on. Sometimes I use the speakers and the piano. So when you put the headphones in, it cuts off the speaker and the piano, right? And then you can listen on your headphones. Very good. Ding, 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 ding. Like that. Late at night, I tend to put those on because I don't want the neighbours to hear all the noise, you see. And I took the headphones out. And I went, oh, there's no sound coming through. I tried again. Nothing. Started pushing buttons on there, nothing. But I turn it on and turn it off again to see what happens. So I did that. And what had happened is that a plug had been broken. I've just got a call on hold there. I'll be with you in a second, my darling, whoever that is. All right, just stay there a second. I'll just finish this off and I'll come to you. The plug had broken. The tip of the plug had broken in the thing. Well, I managed to get it out. What I did, I looked up on the internet and people suggested trying this. Put a bit of glue on a, I actually used a screwdriver, okay? I put that up the hole, like that, okay? And then let it sit, pulled it out, and I had to try twice before it worked, but then it worked. How fantastic is that? Now, it didn't come all the way out, but it's got it out past that thing there. Have I told you this already? I've got a feeling I've told you this already, haven't I? So I got it past that bit up there, which means the speakers work now. There's two headphone sockets, so I can just use the other one, really. OK, now, who was that just calling in? Call back if you want to, my darlings, and I'll take your call now, all right? Hello to Dino, 020-8144-3477. Your last chance to call in now, boys and girls, before I disappear this evening and go out for my nighttime walk. I might have a cup of tea first, actually. I'll probably have a cup of tea first and I'll go out for a nighttime walk. But 020-8144-3477, any final calls today, OK? The Callum says The Voice was on tonight. Yes, I haven't seen The Voice yet. I haven't actually seen The Voice yet. Gary, people could make a donation. No, I tend not to ask people for money or anything like that. No, I don't really do that. Hello, who's on the line now, please?
Hello, it's Wendy.
Hello, Wendy. All right, darling. How lovely to hear you, love. How marvellous to hear your voice. Do you know, it must be a year and a half since you called into this live programme, I'm sure it was.
It's not far. It can't be far off that.
It must be something like that. What can I do for you tonight, my love?
Oh, it was just, I was going back to the beginning when you were talking about nasty neighbours.
Oh, yeah?
Well, when I lived in Manchester, I bought a, before I was married, I bought an ex-council flat.
Oh, that's how I started, yeah, yeah.
Yeah, and they were in a block of four, and there was a young lady underneath, lived there with a young son of about 3 years old.
Right.
And they, at first it was okay, you know, your new neighbours, they're all nicey-nicey. And then about 2 months after I'd moved in, it started. She didn't work, and they were playing loud music.
Yeah.
Boom, boom. You know, I was working full time then.
Right.
And
we
were playing music till like 3 or 4 o'clock in the morning. And of course, I had to be up for work. In the end, what I had to do, and it went on, there were people coming in and out till banging doors 3 or 4 o'clock in the morning.
Oh.
It was that type of place. And the worst thing was, there was a young lad that lived up the road with his mum, but they weren't getting on. So social services had him move out and move in under me with this girl. And he was a nightmare.
The noise.
He was an absolute nightmare.
You see, it must...
aggressive and... sorry, go on.
It must be just dreadful to not be able to get away from that noise.
It was.
Oh.
It was. In the end, I had to contact environmental health. And we had a lady come out and, you know, she put the monitor in and to measure the noise and all that. And she actually came to my flat and she said, I can hear this noise while I'm sat here. And she said, that wouldn't be acceptable to me. And eventually she was evicted.
Well, good. But all that time, of course, once you've reported them and then the council starts speaking to them, then did you suffer abuse yourself because of that?
Mm.
Yeah, you see, this is the trouble. What do? Do you say something? Or do you hope it...
A couple of times we did say something, and my brother actually moved in with me, my youngest brother, who's no longer with us, moved in with me for a short time.
Yeah.
It was just... the arguments... In the end, I just stopped communication with her because it was just getting aggressive. And that's when I got in touch with Environmental Health and had them come in. Awful. And they sorted it, they dealt with it, and they evicted her eventually.
On
the other hand, where I'm living in now, in Leyland, I've got fantastic neighbours. I couldn't wish for better people around me. They're just wonderful.
Same here. See, wonderful. I'm very lucky.
Like, for example, just when John was ill, we had a really bad storm one night, and it was when I had the two dogs. And about 2 or 3 o'clock in the morning, one of my neighbours across the road was still up, and he noticed that and I was still up because the dogs were out in the garden.
Yeah.
And he noticed that the gate had fallen down, including the fence.
Yes.
And the dogs got out, and he come knocking on my door. He said, "Your dogs are out." And first off, he went and got the dogs.
He collected your dogs for you?
Yeah, he collected my dogs for me, brought them back, and then fixed the fence at 3 or 4 o'clock in the morning.
Oh, that's all you can want for good neighbours.
Yeah, they're just amazing, amazing people, especially those two across the road are called Paul and Nicola, and they're just amazing neighbours, and I just love them to bits.
That's wonderful. If
we all get on really, really well, but it's just one extreme to the other.
Yeah. If I ever had noisy neighbours, if Dave and Karen ever moved out next door and I got noisy neighbours, that would be it. I'd be gone.
Yeah.
I'd probably go out to my sister's, to be honest. I'd go up that way. That's probably the only thing that would force me to move. Noisy neighbours, and it would do my head in. There's actually someone round here, and in the summer, and I can't find out what house it is. In the summer, you can be sitting in the garden, so much peace, birds singing and all that business, and then it starts, and it sounds like sawing wood.
Oh, that's annoying.
And he's not close. They don't need to be close by for that.
It's just the vibrations, isn't it?
He's some distance away in one of the other houses, and it does my head in when that starts.
Mm.
It really does. I can't stand. Isn't it funny, like being a DJ and doing all that karaoke, and yet at home, I can't stand noise.
Mm.
I really
can't. Well, that's your job, isn't it?
You know, yeah, I suppose
so. That's your job. When you come home, you're in your own space and you're in your own environment, and you just want to be.
Well, you do.
You know, you want to rest and be quiet and
you do
relax. If there's noise going on, it's more mentally harming than anything else.
Yeah, I think so. But when you go to a Barry Manilow concert, it can't be loud enough, can it? Isn't that funny? You know, we need more volume from Barry. Incidentally, Wendy is the lady who buys me these calendars every year now. This is the third one you've bought me, this Barry Manilow 2017 calendar. You can't see him very well in that picture, sort of from the distance. It's gone crooked now. Look, something's gone crooked. I can't stand a crooked picture, Wendy.
I know.
Oh, thanks for calling, and it's lovely. Have you got any messages from anyone who's watching? It's a few of your friends are watching tonight, I see.
Yeah, Eloise. I think Eloise may be still there. Maybe Elaine is still there.
Elaine's there.
Hi,
yeah.
Elaine. I don't know if any of the other Manilow girls. Maybe Rosemary. Rosemary Dixon. Maybe she's. I don't. Do you know what? I'm sat here waving.
Oh well, wave then. That's okay. They can see you. They can see you.
I'm sat here waving, like, hello. Why am I doing that? Crazy woman.
As much as you want, my darling. I do all sorts of strange things downstairs on my own. Make noises. I dance around the room. I conduct entire orchestras sometimes in front of the television.
I know you do.
Usually the Royal Philharmonic Orchestra. You know the chap who usually conducts for Barry Manilow?
Ron,
yeah. Yeah, that's him. Sometimes I push him to the side when I've got the DVD on and I actually take over his job conducting for him. So he sits down and has a rest in the corner, you know. Thank you, Wendy. Lovely to talk to you, darling.
And you.
Have a lovely evening, all right?
Yeah, you too.
Ta-ra.
Bye.
Lovely to hear from Wendy calling in from northwest, somewhere further up than Watford. That's it, Watford. Tony says, congratulations to Sutton United for holding football, Tony. Football, no one's interested in football here, dear. We're not interested in football. We don't do football on this programme. I can't think of anything more boring than football. Thank you. Tweety says, great show tonight. I rarely get to catch the live shows from the US. Thank you very much. That's all right. Everyone's waving back to you. Eloise, Elaine, they're all waving back to you, Wendy. So don't think you're on your own there, my darling. Never, ever think you're on your own. Right, I'm going to disappear now, boys and girls. Time to go. Oh, I know you want me to stay here for at least another 5 hours solid, doesn't it? No, I'm going to go now because I need to go and have a walk. I feel the need for exercise. And maybe I might stop at the BB Garage and get a very small bar of Galaxy Dairy Milk Chocolate. Because I haven't had any sweet stuff today at all. I don't think I have anyway. Have I had any sweet stuff? Oh, hang on a minute. No, I have. I bought an apple pie. I bought an apple pie from the co-op. It's gone up, dear. It's gone up four. I think it's gone up 17. But used to be a pound. It's now £1.17. God, well, I hope I've got an extra half an apple in the pastry for that or something like that. Thank you very much today, boys and girls. Be another show tomorrow, either live or recorded. I'm not sure what we're doing tomorrow. All right, so I'll let you know then. Have a wonderful Saturday evening. And remember, if you haven't seen it yet, do watch Let It Shine on the BBC iPlayer. You won't be disappointed. Thanks for watching and listening. I'll see you soon. Cheerio now.